Good afternoon, welcome to Choral Evensong here at Llandaff. A particularly warm welcome to representatives from the North Cardiff ministry area for whom we are praying on our cycle of prayer today. Welcome too if you are joining us online. Diolch am wylio. Psalm appointed for this evening is Psalm 33. We sit while the choir chants the psalm.
Thank you. first lesson is written in the book of Numbers, chapter 9, beginning at verse 15. On the day the tabernacle was set up, the cloud covered the tabernacle, the tent of the covenant. And from evening until morning, it was over the tabernacle, having the appearance of fire. It was always so. The cloud covered it by day, and the appearance of fire by night. Whenever the cloud lifted from over the tent, then the Israelites would set out. And in the place where the cloud settled down, there the Israelites would camp. At the command of the Lord, the Israelites would set out, and at the command of the Lord, they would camp. As long as the cloud rested over the tabernacle, they would remain in camp. Even when the cloud continued over the tabernacle for many days, the Israelites would keep the charge of the Lord and would not set out. Sometimes the cloud would remain for a few days over the tabernacle, and according to the command of the Lord, they would remain in camp. Then, according to the command of the Lord, they would set out. Sometimes the cloud would remain from evening until morning, and when the cloud lifted in the morning, they would set out. Or if it continued for a day and a night, when the cloud lifted, they would set out. Whether it was 2 days or a month, or a longer time, that the cloud continued over the tabernacle, resting upon it, the Israelites would remain in camp and would not set out. But when it lifted, they would set out. At the command of the Lord, they would camp. And at the command of the Lord, they would set out. They kept the charge of the Lord at the command of the Lord by Moses. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. second lesson is taken from the first letter of the Corinthians, chapter 7, beginning at verse 17. However that may be, let each of you lead the life that the Lord has assigned, to which God called you. This is my rule in all the churches. Was anyone at the time of his call already circumcised? Let him not seek to remove the marks of circumcision. Was anyone at the time of his call uncircumcised? Let him not seek circumcision. Circumcision is nothing, and uncircumcision is nothing, but obeying the commandments of God is everything. Let each of you remain in the condition in which you were called. Were you a slave when called? Do not be concerned about it. Even if you can gain your freedom, make use of your present condition now more than ever. For whoever was called in the Lord as a slave is a freed person belonging to the Lord, just as whoever was free when called is a slave of Christ. You were bought with a price. Do not become slaves of human masters. In whatever condition you were called, brothers and sisters, there remain with God. Here ends the second.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
The anthem, Even Such Is Time, words attributed to Sir Walter Raleigh, set to music by Bob Chilcott.
Let us pray. We thank you, O loving Father, for the blessings you have given us. Over the centuries, your prophets spoke of all that was to come, and which is now revealed and redeemed in your Son. We praise you for the story of salvation and thank you for our part in it, and we know that the best is yet to come. We pray for your people throughout the world, praying for our own diocese and Bishop June, and particularly today praying for the ministry area of North Cardiff. For the Reverend Jim Griffiths, the ministry area leader, the lay chair, Eleanor Williams, the wardens, and all the ministry area council. And as the ministry area has its first vestry meeting this month and its inaugural service, we pray for this new beginning in that part of the diocese. We ask for the guidance of the Holy Spirit. We ask for the willingness to go where the Spirit leads, just as the Israelites of old moved in the wilderness as the cloud directed them over the tabernacle. We pray for a spirit of collaboration, and that all will see the benefits of working together in unity as God's people in each of our ministry areas. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Create in your church an openness to your words and a clear vision of where we need to be in our own discipleship. Bless lay and ordained ministers, and call more people into this service. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the world into which your Son was born. Help us to recognize what is precious and priceless in our world, and to value it, from human life to the air we breathe, from the water we drink to the creatures who share our planet, from the peace we seek to the relationship with you that we need to fulfill our deepest longings. Pray especially for the parts of the world where all is not well, including Afghanistan, the Yemen, Ukraine, many other places of suffering and conflict. Bring peace with justice and compassion, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We think of those who are sick or suffering in any way. We ask for their burden to be lifted, their anxieties calmed. We pray for hope and courage in difficult circumstances. We give thanks for those who care, whether with or without medical training, at home and in hospital. We pray for patience in our difficulties and a sense of your companionship through all that we go through. May each person we hold in our hearts this evening know your love and feel your presence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We remember those who have passed into your closer presence, including those whose anniversary falls today: John Henry Anderson, Francis Kerrigan, Stephen Alan Granger, Frederick Edmund Pollard. May they know the peace of your eternal kingdom. May those who mourn be comforted in their memories and through the love of those around them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Thanks be to thee, Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits thou hast won for me, for all the pains and insults thou hast borne for me. O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may I know thee more clearly, love thee more dearly, and follow thee more nearly, day by day. Amen. We close our prayers with the words of the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
sing the hymn, Jesu, the very thought of thee with sweetness fills my breast. Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you and scatter the darkness from before your path. A bendith diw holl a lliog, a tad a mab ar ysbryd glan, a fo a naill plith, ac a drigo gyda chwi yn wastad,